make sure you stick around until the end to see how you can win free gear and products. Hey, this is PJ with CLK Supplies, and welcome back to another key machine battle. Well, as a matter of fact, we're going to be doing what we want to call today is a speed test. And we have Javon. Thanks for coming back on.
Oh, you're welcome. Good to be here.
And we have Kid Lock.
Hello. Great
Kid Lock, man. You're looking buff, man. You're looking, you've been working out.
Quart of Pennzoil.
Yeah, so quart of Pennzoil.
I'm ready for this over the top. Let's get it done.
Awesome. All right, so is what we're doing today is we're going to be putting up the Framon 2 code machine up against the HPC 1200. Now, in this particular battle, we're just going to be doing a speed test. That's one thing that we hear a lot about when it comes to the Framon 2 versus the HPC. Like, there's probably a huge speed difference. What does that look like? And so it's what I figured what we do. I bring in two guys that use HPC key machines, Kid Lock and Javon, many times, many years.
Yeah, every day.
And I just gave them a really basic, quick training on the Framon 2 machine. And so we're gonna really see real life. What does it look like going from a HPC 1200 to a Framon 2? And what does that speed look like cutting the key? So we're gonna be cutting a KW1 key, just really basic, run of the mill. We're gonna have some fun. Do you guys have any thoughts to begin with before we get going here?
Well, no, I think it's going to be fun. I mean, it's something that we're neither one of us are familiar with. So
yeah,
I think
we just had a 30-second class.
Yeah, 30-second class.
About 30 seconds.
Yeah,
we
embarrass ourselves.
Perfect. Well, all right. So what we'll do is, I guess, Kid Lock, we'll have you start with the 1200.
Okay.
Javon, we'll have you start with the Framon, and then when you guys cut a key, stop, we'll wait for the other person, and then we'll talk about it for a second. We'll swap and do it again.
Okay. Okay.
All right.
Let's go. Let's do it.
Cool.
On your marks, get set. All right, so there you have it. So, Kid Lock, it looks like, you know, you got done sooner. I mean, is this like another day?
That's the second time using that.
Yep, second time. Now, John, as you were using the machine, as you were doing this, and you could hear Tanner cutting, like, I mean, were you trying, like, getting a little flustered with it?
No,
or, like,
no.
What were you thinking?
No, I was just trying to focus on it because I'm not familiar with it. I think I'm better than I was the first key that I cut.
Yeah.
So there's going to be a learning curve. You're going to get faster at it. We've been working on the HPCs for about a year, so.
Yep. Yeah.
But, you know, there's a learning curve. It's going to be different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I mean, what's your first initial impression using the machine?
You know, it's really tight. It works really smooth. I do like the fact that you can go right to the numbers. It's very precise. Mm-hmm. And I think you don't tend to overshoot. Like with the HPC, I get in repetition and I'll go real fast.
Oh, I'm going
and
right
I'll
past
overpass, you know. And so I think this prevents that a little bit. You have to be a little more precise. So,
okay.
Yeah.
But, yeah. Awesome. Well, let's go ahead and switch.
Okay.
And we'll see how it goes.
I haven't got your key out.
Oh, perfect. Okay.
It'd make me quicker.
It's completely different.
Yeah, that's interesting. So, Javon, for you cutting that, it was just another day, right? Good luck. Can we talk to us about while you're doing that? Could you feel a little pressure with Javon sitting over there spinning those dials?
Yeah, because I'm trying to win.
It's a battle. Yeah, absolutely.
I just got my butt kicked.
Yeah.
But the numbers, I'm not a number guy. The numbers scare me, but it's actually very simple. If I could do it, anybody can do it. I don't know how I can explain that.
Okay, so going in,
I can do it, you can do it.
So 30 minutes ago,
yeah,
you have never cut a key on a frame before.
No, I was scared when you were showing me prior a couple weeks ago. You're like, check this out.
Yeah.
And the lock father is like, he doesn't really like these, they're never used them.
Yeah.
So when you told me the lock father wasn't really fond of them, I kind of got scared a little bit, but using it, I take it.
Okay.
Instead of fussing through cards, that's a cool thing.
Yeah.
If you have all your cards in order, it's still, you gotta get your key code anyway, type in your key code, get your numbers.
Yeah.
Good to go.
Yep. Yeah, definitely good to go. Yeah. So, the question I think we have to just talk about briefly here is how, from your perspective, so this is like a speed test, and I also want to include effort in it. If, how much effort and is required to cut on a frame and two over a HPC machine, a 1200?
How much effort? There's really no more effort. You just have just a different way of doing it.
Okay.
The effort really isn't.
Is it much more?
It's a very similar process. I think one of the things that I think that we're not really showing here is that time you're searching for a card and trying to find the right card. Did you misplace the card?
Right.
Those kind of things where the Framon, you're just getting started. If you have your numbers,
yeah,
you're going.
Yep.
So that could have changed things too. So there's part of a process that would change it. Yeah.
And an interesting part about the Framon that the cuts that we were cutting was a 3-1-4-5-4, right? And the fact on the fours, you can cut them all together.
Yeah, right.
If, depending on what the key bidding is, it can get really quick.
Right.
On the frame and two.
Absolutely. If you got three fours boom, you're done with those. You're on the next one.
Yeah, and so I think it's obvious here that the clear winner is going to be the 1200 due to the speed of cutting itself.
Right.
However, the big question to ask is, if you had to cut 100 keys on one of these machines, which machine are you going to want to cut them on?
1200.
Yeah. Probably the
1200.
Okay. Because I'm born and raised with the 1200.
Yeah, that's fair.
I think if I was fixing keys, though, if I had, like we were talking about previous to this, is that if there was a key that was worn out that I was trying to figure out what the problem is. So we all know sometimes, you get a worn out key and you're trying to figure out exactly what that pin should be.
Absolutely.
The Framon's going to, I think, adjust that much better than anything else.
Absolutely. Yeah. But it was kind of a trick question, because the truth is, if you need to cut 100 keys, you only want to cut one on the code. You want to duplicate the rest. So I kind of tricked both of you guys on that one.
Okay.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I'm thinking while you're talking, I'm thinking, man, what a perfect machine for beginner locksmith. we got spoiled on 1200s where we're just going, we're not even looking at depth numbers. We're not looking at, you know, space numbers.
Yeah.
This is getting you to know your space numbers and your depth numbers, and you'll have them memorized where,
you just
get the key code. You're just a 3, 5, 4, 5, 1. You already know those depths. You're using the pins. You're using those same depths. You're gonna familiarize yourself on pin size, the depths, the spaces. A great learning tool as far as getting started.
Right, that's right. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely right.
Yeah, I think over time it just makes you better.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
So, yeah. Awesome. Well, Javon, Kid Lock, thank you guys for coming on here and experimenting essentially live on camera with Framon 2.
Awesome, it was a fun deal. Yeah.
All right, everybody, well, thank you for watching. We'd love to know in the comments below what you think. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.
See ya.
I'm guessing if you just watched this video that you work with locks and keys. And to us here at CLK Supplies, that makes you a lock boss. And we wanna hook you up. Here's how it works. Throughout the week, we post videos on YouTube, like the one you just watched. And all you need to do is comment on the videos and include the hashtag lockboss. When you do this, you're automatically entered in to win one of 5 free prizes that we give out each and every week. No purchase necessary. So if you're a lock boss, join us each week to learn, grow, and win.